What's up, everybody? Welcome back to more GTA. My name is Raven from the Sky. Let's do this.
All right, look, let's go. Start heading over to the Pacific Bluff Country Club. We'll be in touch, all right? Tell them what's going on, all
right? Right, so when you get there, find the surveillance room. Break into it. Then you're gonna use the USB I gave you to hack into the security footage and upload it to our network so I can scan for leads.
I walked under it. I shouldn't have activated. Oh my God. I walked under it. How did it?
Okay, I got it. We're only a few hours behind. The data left in the limousine. I just ran the limo's registration through every database I can get to. It's registered to some shell company. No address, no employee list.
Damn. Sounds like a dead end to me.
Yeah, except it got flagged speeding on the traffic camera network. Here's the last known location.
All right, I got it. Shit, let's go.
I know they have a stranglehold on this country. 50% of my ex-husband's wealth. Like many women, I said one thing before we got married, then stopped doing any of those things afterwards, and acted indignantly when my husband got upset. And that ability to lie, change my mind, makes me perfect for elected office. Now I'm ready to sign a contract with our great state and be your next governor, because I've proven I'm someone you can trust to break their word.
Okay, you just want to follow it. Looks like it's down a passenger since it got flagged, so we have to assume the data's not on board. Just keep your distance and see where it goes.
Thinking about the gaping hole in our nation's security. We have to...
Hey, look, if they see you and get spooked, do what you gotta do to get some intel on that driver. Take his ass out. Get his ID and bring it back to you.
But at the same time, I'm gonna try to do it the stealth way and not get spooked. I'm glad that there's a plan B, though. It's not just automatic mission fail, you know what I mean? That's so old. You get automatic mission fails and got to start all over again. Anybody trying to do that?
Clean air to breathe, clean bottled water to drink, and most of all, that the rich will pay their fair share, which I compute to be about 82.5% of all future income. So what you're saying, Sue, is you've made a lot of money, and going forward, nobody else will be able to.
Exactly. I'm very wealthy. I'm making sacrifices, so the middle class will have to get on board too. It stands to reason,
does it?
Yes. If we want a fairer world, it stands to reason that you need a rich, impartial person to tell you how to make it fair. This is something Vinewood understands implicitly, and I'm going to take it across the state. Let's get back on track. I think we have a health crisis in this country, and people should have the medicine they need. Proposition 208.
Yes, Fernando loves medical cocaine. I say, pretty lady, you look like you are not feeling well. I will help you. I have put a row of medicine down there for you. Oh, yes. She's feeling much better now. Maybe you want to take it like a suppository. Poof.
Yes, yes, okay. We have some people on the phone who have questions for Miss Murray.
Okay, line 8. Hello, you are on the Fernando show with Sue Murray.
Yeah, hi. Fan,
where is it going? I wonder if we're gonna get any other VIPs besides Dr. Dre. But so far, it seems like the whole contract is centered around him and getting his music back. Get his phone back.
Wherever it's going, make sure you get the pick, all right?
Just the entrance will do. Send it to me.
Alan McLean. I mean, you should never, ever, ever lay a hand on a child.
This is true. Don't touch that child. You will get in big trouble if someone is watching.
Now, you talked earlier about the debt ceiling. That's a big issue that is too often politicized. A lot of professional women in this state are hitting a glass ceiling.
The debt ceiling.
I'll investigate the owner, but I say maybe back off for now.
Yeah, all right, but shit, we gonna need to find a real good reason to come back here.
And the access code for that gate.
For sure. Look, let's find out who owned this motherfucker and regroup, all right? We'll be in touch.
Thank you.
Hurry up and call, woman. How long is it gonna take?
China plate. I've got a minor major wardrobe malfunction developing out here on a Costa Del kind of music. Don't ask for details. It ain't pretty. We need some fresh merch flown over ASAP. I figured you'd be the one to make it happen. Well, if you can bear to have that on your conscience, so be it. I'll go be the messenger. Ta-ra.
Get back to the office whenever you're ready.
See you soon.
All right. See how we can get into that mansion.
Looking good, boss.
What you got for us on that mansion?
So it belongs to Ben Brooks, crypto investor. Billionaire, of course.
What the hell he want with Dre Music?
Yeah, it's weird, right? So I did a little digging, and it looks like he wants to use it as an NFT.
And you think he gonna sell this thing or what?
Yeah, he's setting up some hyper-exclusive gathering at his place to do a world premiere and put it up for auction.
Oh, shit. Okay, well look, let's get our associate on that guest list.
All right, let's go.
What's up, boss?
So this crypto dude, Ben Brooks, he's planning to auction off that NFT at an exclusive cocktail event at his place. We need a way in. And if I know anything about these big tech motherfuckers, their lawyer's always on speed dial and always got a front door key. Imani's got that motherfucker's address. Now let's go pay his ass a visit.
Thank you.
Okay, look, we're gonna need some alone time with this lawyer if we're gonna persuade his ass to give us the access code to this fucking port. You're gonna need to get him back to the office alive, all right?
And if we take his car too, we can use it to get past the gate at the mansion.
Oh shit, hell yeah, good call. Look, let's do this shit right, though. Start with getting past the dude's security. When you get to him, use the stun gun I set you up with. Should knock his ass out cold.
All right. Okay. Where the heck are you? How? What the?
Give it up, ass! Oh no!
I alerted the whole doggone. But they would have been aggro when I first walked in there. It was right in front of me. Oh my god.
Oh!
Oh, so that was him. Gotta get up there first. Oh my god. Got a whole army up there. Oh, you coming with me? Ooh. All right, guys, thanks for watching. My name is Raven from the Sky. If you enjoyed the episode, make sure to drop a like and subscribe to the channel and the series grow. Take care, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Peace out.